Why has a century-old bridge been a constant source of delays for Northeast commuters? In this video, we'll reveal how New Jersey's $2.4 billion replacement, the Portal North Bridge, will finally solve one of the East Coast's most notorious rail bottlenecks. The Portal Bridge has long been a frustration along the Northeast Corridor, grinding train traffic to a halt each time it fails. But, at long last, a solution is on the way. The new Portal North Bridge, designed to handle modern rail demands without the usual breakdowns. So, what exactly will this new bridge offer? And how will it reshape travel across one of the nation's busiest rail corridors? Let's take a closer look at the solution behind this massive investment. Before we bridge the gap on how the Portal North Bridge is set to fix New Jersey's rail woes, make sure to subscribe to Design Zip for the latest updates on groundbreaking infrastructure projects. The Portal Bridge was built in 1910. Now it is the backbone of the Northeast Corridor, connecting New Jersey to New York City over the Hackensack River. It was constructed by the Pennsylvania Railroad, back when rail was the height of modern transportation. They didn't skimp, creating a two-track swing bridge that swung open for boats and sent trains hurtling towards the brand new Penn Station in Manhattan. This was cutting-edge stuff, and it quickly became the go-to route for anyone looking to move between New Jersey and the Big Apple. After a few decades, the Portal Bridge became the hotspot for train travel. Amtrak and NJ Transit trains packed the tracks, turning it into a critical rail artery for the entire region. By the 2000s, this bridge was handling more than 450 trains every single day, filled up to 200,000 passengers. That's right, this steel span saw an endless parade of commuters, tourists, and travellers zipping back and forth over the Hackensack. It is not just about the numbers, though. This 961-foot-long bridge is a swing span, meaning it can rotate to let boats pass underneath. With a clearance of just 20 feet, it had to swing open to make room for ships. It was a clever solution back in 1910, but it quickly became clear that the bridge's true value was in keeping those trains moving. Over the years, the bridge has become a legend in the world of rail. It has seen the addition of electric lines, handled millions of passengers, and made its mark as an important part of the region's transportation network. For over a century, the Portal Bridge has been getting commuters where they need to go, no matter the time of day. But there have been some issues, issues that are now too critical to just ignore. For all its history and importance, the Portal Bridge has been a major pain point for decades. The first major issue is the swing span design. With only 20 feet of clearance above the Hackensack River, the Portal Bridge must pivot open to allow boats to pass underneath. This was a smart idea over a century ago, but now it is one of the biggest sources of frustration. Every time the bridge swings open, train traffic grinds to a halt, and getting the bridge back into place can be unpredictable. It does not always close correctly, and when it does, it often requires a team of workers to manually lock the rails in place. In fact, one out of every seven times the bridge opens, it fails to close properly, causing delays that ripple across the entire Northeast Corridor. When a swing bridge cannot swing back, it is a problem. There have been some particularly infamous incidents over the years. In 1996, a major derailment occurred when the bridge didn't close properly. The tracks were not aligned, creating a 5-inch difference that caused the train to jump the rails. 34 passengers were injured, and the incident caused millions in damages. The response was to slow trains crossing the bridge to 60 miles per hour. But that only increased the delays for everyone involved. In 2005, things got even worse when the bridge caught fire. Faulty electrical wires overhead heated up and sparked, setting the creosote covered wooden supports ablaze. All rail traffic was halted until the fire was controlled, causing a massive disruption for commuters. The repairs alone cost $5 million. Nearly a decade later, in 2014, the bridge caught fire again, leading to another shutdown and a scramble to get the bridge back in service. These malfunctions have serious economic and environmental impacts. When the bridge gets stuck, it throws off train schedules up and down the corridor, from Boston to Washington, D.C. Passengers are left waiting, freight gets delayed, and costs pile up. Between 2014 and 2018, the aging Portal Bridge, along with the nearby North River Tunnel, contributed to over 2,000 hours of delays. Even routine maintenance is a nightmare. Due to the bridge's age, the mechanical and electrical components require constant upkeep, which costs millions every year just to keep things from falling apart. Any repair work has to be carefully scheduled to avoid peak commuter hours, which further complicates the process. The final straw is the bridge's inability to support higher speed trains. With modern rail technology advancing, the Portal Bridge remains stuck in the past. It limits trains to a maximum of 60 miles per hour. As demand for faster, more reliable service grows, the need for a modern replacement has become impossible to ignore. Simply put, the Portal Bridge is outdated, unreliable, and in desperate need of a 21st century upgrade to match the demands of the busiest rail corridor in the nation. This is why the government came up with a creative solution. The government is replacing the Portal Bridge, and it is a critical component of the broader Gateway project, which aims to modernize and expand rail infrastructure between New York, New Jersey, and New York City. The new solution, which is the Portal North Bridge, is a $2.4 billion investment designed to eliminate the problems of the old bridge and increase the reliability. The plan for the Portal North Bridge is to replace the outdated swing span with a modern, high-level, fixed-span bridge. Unlike the current bridge, the new structure will be 50 feet above the Hackensack River, which will allow boats to pass underneath without the need for the bridge to open and close. This eliminates the malfunction risks that have plagued the old design. It will make sure we get a smooth flow of both rail and river traffic. Construction of the Portal North Bridge is well underway. In October 2021, NJ Transit awarded a $1.56 billion construction contract to Skanska Trailer Brothers joint venture. Construction officially began in August 2022, and the work is projected to take about 5.5 years. The first track is scheduled to be operational in November 2025, with the entire project expected to be completed by early 2027. The old Portal Bridge will be demolished in 2028 once the new bridge is fully functional. The new structure will maintain a two-track design, similar to the old bridge, but with modern upgrades to support faster and heavier trains. The tracks will allow speeds of up to 90 miles per hour, which will be a huge improvement over the current limit of 60 miles per hour. This means that while the number of tracks remain the same, the efficiency of train movements will be much greater. The fixed span design will cut down on maintenance costs, save millions in yearly repairs, and reduce the risk of costly accidents. Though the Portal North Bridge won't immediately increase train capacity, it will remain at 24 trains per hour in each direction. The project is laying the groundwork for future expansions. A proposed companion bridge, the Portal South Bridge, is in the planning stages. The government has hopes of adding two more tracks to the corridor. If funding can be secured, this future project would double the number of trains able to cross the Hackensack River. This will significantly increase capacity for both Amtrak and NJ Transit services. The construction project is complex as it involves the installation of retaining walls, deep foundations, concrete piers, structural steel spans and modern rail systems. The bridge will stretch 2.5 miles, including the approaches on either side. Demolition of the existing portal bridge will be a delicate operation, as it must be carefully removed without disrupting current rail services during construction. Funding for the Portal North Bridge has come from a mix of sources. The US Department of Transportation, Federal Transit Administration, New Jersey Turnpike Authority, and Amtrak have all contributed. In January 2021, a major milestone was reached when a full funding grant agreement secured $766.5 million in federal funding for the project. New Jersey is also heavily invested, with the state providing a substantial financial support to make sure the project stays on track. So, that's how the new Portal North Bridge aims to solve one of the East Coast's biggest transit bottlenecks, boosting reliability, safety, and speed for commuters. What do you think? Will this be enough to improve travel in the Northeast, or should there be more changes? Share your thoughts in the comments below. And if you're interested in more insights into architecture, design, and construction, subscribe to Design Zip for future updates. Thanks for watching, and see you in the next one.